Hi guys, so I'm just recording some more Lords of the Fallen gameplay. So there was actually a recent update and I think it's made the performance a bit better. So actually I was able to play this with everything on Ultra. I mean, I can see this one, I've just left it on the default, but later on in the game, in the gameplay capture, I actually just change everything to Ultra. I have 72 hertz with asynchronous spacewalk forced on, so it only has to hit 36 hertz, and then it doubles up. And with DLSS, pretty much quality, all balanced. I mean, the first kind of major boss at the end of the video, probably should have it balanced. So probably don't need it all on ultra, it's probably some stuff on high. But it looks really amazing now, and you can totally play this 72 hertz with asynchronous spacewalk. It feels pretty good. Further on in the video, you'll see me change everything to medium. So changing everything to medium, I can turn asynchronous spacewalk off, because with the previous settings like high, ultra kind of stuff, I was getting about 49 hertz, so I did have a bit of headroom to meet that 36. So changing it down to medium settings, I was able to get a pretty solid 72 hertz. So medium settings, DLSS kind of balance, performance basically, and anywhere between 2,500 to about close to 3,000, you could get the resolution in UEVR. Actually, I'm probably going to play it with asynchronous spacewalk on because the effects are amazing. It looks really good, really, really good, and hopefully with some DLSS updates, it might get even better. For some reason, the update changed all my settings, so I have to go in and change the brightness a bit, because you can see it's just a little bit washed out when I'm playing. I don't know, it's quite like my crunchy blacks. But yeah, it's quite a long gameplay video. I'm kind of still, I rushed through the tutorial just testing the game, so I need to figure out how to kill the little blue things without dying in the umbral realm. But yeah, it's pretty amazing game. I'm really hype for this. I'll probably stream a longer gameplay where I start again from the beginning, because I'm just kind of rushing through this. I'm not like taking my time enjoying it, because I'm just trying to kind of test it. You can see I'm resetting the UI, just kind of, I like it small, and you can't tell this from the video, but it's like I like it close to me, like in a specific position in my vision. Yeah, trying that. Yeah, I've got the deluxe edition, so I've got these tints. Also, at the end of the video, I try out the model viewer, which is pretty cool. And when you take a photo, it kind of saves the scene in this with the photo mode, and you can go back to the scenes you have, and it's just like, it just loads the world, and you look around in VR. So the photo mode is really awesome. So playing this like Dark Crusader class is kind of heavy. I don't know if I might try again with like an archer or dex build, as they say. I need to try co-op. I need to arrange someone. I don't know who else is to get the game, play some co-op. So I'm not quite sure how the system works. I don't know if I need an item or something. There's like a login button. I'm kind of scared. I don't want to get like insta banned. So, oh yeah, another thing I did, I actually raised the saturation quite a bit, because seeing the difference in the headset, it pops way more. It looks a bit more extreme on the video capture that I can see, but it seems way better in the headset with more saturation. Yeah, definitely more contrast. I mean, slightly, I think the brightness can stay about the same. You can lower it a little bit if you want deeper blacks. Yeah, really cool. Yeah, this, I'm recording this at 2K as well while I'm playing this, so probably shouldn't do that while if you're trying to get the smoothest performance. But yeah, enjoy. It's a pretty long video. It's like 45 minutes. Yeah, I get towards the end segment, and you can see me in this first one. I kind of do the run with the different settings to see kind of the performance. I do have the performance graph overlay, and I didn't want to record it as well, because I'd have to record the mirror of that and then crop it and put it on the bottom of the screen. I've done that before in some games, but I need every single bit of performance. But yeah, this is really great. And I play, by the way, in like a tiny miniature scale, which you can't see in the video, but just imagine in mixed reality, like little action figures in front of you. That's like the scale that I'm seeing right now when I'm playing the game. But yeah, this is, I really want to do like a long stream of this. Be really cool. Anyway, thanks guys, thanks for watching. Check on Twitter, I posted some mixed reality stuff of the fish game. Looks pretty cool. Trying to think of some of the mixed reality games to try out with VD, virtual desktop. Okay, cool. I'll leave you to it.
You carry the lamp long enough and you'll see history repeat over and over. If you don't want to keep retreading the same ground yourself should you fall, make use of this. I've given you more umbral guidance than I ever had. From now on, find your own way and stay out of mine. I've given you more umbral guidance.
By your radiance, grant me the strength to continue to endure these dark days, to lay bare the path to salvation for my wayward brothers and sisters, so we may walk it together and to strike down all those who would see our will defied. Even as our suffering continued, I honored my pledge of patience to the Exactor. And yet you now appear before me, a stranger, bearing what was not yours to receive. A betrayal made flesh, and one I cannot brook.